will be more effective. Now coming to this Scrum. Scrum is an agile method. Scrum is a simple management framework. So at lot of places you will find that Scrum has several processes, but believe me, it's just a framework. You have to set, or the team has to set their own processes to proceed within the agile framework. For incremental, so Scrum is a simple management framework for incremental product development using one of the more cross-functional and self-organizing teams. Scrum teams use called sprints. So sprint word and iteration word is normally used interchangeably. Typically 2 weeks to 4 weeks long, they attempt to build a potential shippable product increment every iteration. So this is basically comes under the principle of agile. Scrum teams are responsible for creating and adapting their processes within this framework. And Scrum provides a simple structure of roles, meetings, rules and artifacts. We have already seen the rules. I will introduce some of the meetings, roles and artifacts. Before that, let's see, let's have a factorial representation of working in Scrum. So if you see this particular portion where this is basically the product owner responsibility with the stakeholder or the client to put a stack of requirements in a proper priority, that is known as project backlog. So this term will be used quite often, project backlog. Then each of the item is selected from the project backlog for the prioritized work. You can say project backlog items every 2 weeks. Suppose our iteration is 2 weeks, or sprint is of 2 weeks. So the team selects how much sprint work or how much task they can complete in particular sprint. So that is known as sprint backlog. So all these are artifacts. This is a sprint of say 2 weeks, 10 days, and this is a daily work that is continuously being monitored, the progress within daily and within this sprint. And at the end of this sprint, a testable or deliverable part of functionality of the product that committed by the team will be shipped. Before shipping, it will be demonstrated to the product so that proper functionality can be finalized and can be released. If any items is not proper, it will be put back into the project backlog so that it can come with the priority for the coming sprints. So this is basically overview of Scrum Agile method. Let's have at Scrum roles. Product owner. So product owner is basically a key stakeholder and represents a user or customer and is responsible for the requirements for the release. Scrum development and QA team. Development and QA team. So although the team member should be cross-functional and should work in the development as well as testing portion, but there are times when you need to separate out these teams. In most of the cases, if your team size is bigger than 7 members, normally you break it into 2 parts, development team and QA team. And the important role is of Scrum Master. The Scrum Master is responsible for making sure the team is as productive as possible. The Scrum Master does this by helping the team to use the Scrum processes properly and by removing all the hurdles and impediments that comes in the progress of the sprint. It normally keeps protecting the team from outside environmental influences. So these are the roles. Scrum artifacts. We have already seen product backlog, item, the individual item in the product backlog, also known as user story. This is a single task that can be completed or that should be completed within one sprint. Then sprint backlog. This is basically all these user story for one sprint. That is the sprint that is going on. Then sprint task. Individual stories, user story should be broken further down to the individual task by the team. Sprint burn down chart. This shows the progress within the sprint, how the sprint is progressing as per this. This is the days, 2 weeks, 10 days, and this is the total hours for the sprint. Ideal situation, your progress should complete at the end of the sprint. Your sprint, all these user stories within the sprint. But if you see, it should be, in actual, it should go like this. So this is sprint burn down chart. You can get many examples over internet with a proper graph to understand it. But the basic concept is on the on one axis, it is the number of hours remaining for the sprint, and on another, it is the number of days remaining. Then product and release burn down chart. This depicts the overall product progress as well as the release progress. I have one question on my window, that what is sprint? So sprint is a predefined cycle where you have to start working, you have to produce, or you have to commit your work that you can complete within that span. If the sprint is finalized for the 2 weeks, the team has to commit the work for 2 weeks that the team can complete within 2 weeks. And then when one sprint completes, there is a start of another 2 week sprint. And the team again commits for the work for the for another sprint. Now, there are some Scrum meetings. Although I have listed a few important and necessary meetings, there can be possibilities of other meetings also. But these four are really important. Every Scrum should have these. Sprint planning meeting, where it has been basically decided how much workload that can be taken in that particular sprint that is starting. Then there is a daily stand-up meeting. You can say daily Scrum, where progress for that particular day is discussed. There should be a small meeting of around 15 minutes where each developer respond on some pre-decided questions, that how much work he completed in the previous day, what all the work he need to complete in the current day, what are the impediments, and how is, if any, delay in its, in his work. What are the impediments? So these things will be discussed or actually reported to the other team members. Sprint review meeting. We also call it a stand up meeting because it is a very small meeting. There is no time to sit. Normally team members stand up around a table and then discuss their progress, report their progress basically to other team members. Sprint review meeting, where this is at the end of the sprint, where all the shippable functionality is demonstrated to the product, accepted by product or rejected by product. So this happens in the sprint review meeting. All the accepted functionalities will be released, and not accepted things should go back to the product backlog. Sprint retrospective meeting. Retrospective meeting is basically to understand what went well, what didn't well, what didn't went well, what should be improved, and what is the lessons learned. So this is the portion where the next sprint, where the lessons learned will be recorded, and the efficiency or the productivity hurdles will be reported. And then it should not happen in the next iteration. This is the basic purpose, to continuously improve the effectiveness of the Scrum. I have few questions in front of me that relates to basic Scrum things. So actually, if I take all these questions, I will switch from my regular, from my reason for this particular webinar.
Yeah, Mr. Dugar.
I will try to address some things. Pardon?
Mr. Dugar, sorry to interrupt you. Mr. Dugar will take up the questions towards the end. Let's first finish the presentation and then we'll take up the questions, right?
Okay.
All right. Thank you.
Now, Scrum benefits. I will go speedily with the benefits. More